As spring comes back to Ohio, nature once again shows signs of life. Along many woodland valleys, Trillium, Ohio's state wildflower, makes a short appearance in all 88 counties of the state. Silver maples, just starting to bud, begin the process of growing new leaves for the season. Vegetation essential for photosynthesis and the production of oxygen. With an abundance of water, even the smallest streams resemble larger creeks and rivers, if only just for a few weeks. Most of this flow is temporary, cyclical runoff, which directs water into forest pools and wetlands. By May and June, fishless pools known as vernal ponds are one of the most diverse of Ohio habitats, supporting thousands of plant and animal species.
And today you're going to be on one of our state scenic rivers. It's a scenic river because it has excellent water quality. There's a lot of different kinds of fish and bugs and birds and you name it here. And that's kind of the purpose of today's trip is to look at some of those things we don't normally think about when we're in the water. Does everybody have life jackets? Do we all have life jackets?
I do.
Good. I told you we'd get you one.
Educational events are an excellent way to get out, experience a river, and at the same time, learn a bit more about unique habitats and species.
We've got two different types of snails in our assessment. A gilled snail and a pouch snail.
Sure you can.
The way you tell the difference is by the opening. You hold the point facing up, and then whatever side the opening's opens on. So if it opens on your right, it's a gilled snail. That's a level one. The other one is called a pouch snail. It opens up on the left.
And well, what we are doing here today is obviously educating and informing the public on what is truly one of the crown jewels of Ohio's dreams, that being the Cocosi River. This is one of the most scenic rivers in the state, one of the highest quality rivers in terms of not only water quality, but also species diversity.
There are two minnow species that are found in this river. They're indicators of good water quality. One's called a big-eyed chub and one's called a streamline chub. And they tend to be in areas just above the ripples and sort of this fast run type habitat. So you can see if I can catch a couple here with the seine, and I've got a little container. You can look at them and pass them around.
So it is just a fantastic resource because the riparian area of the river is intact. And we also have very good access points for people to safely launch and retrieve their boats, which is also important.